Reverb is a friend. I have a friend in reverb. Reverb is a friend.
Play clock at 5. Pass is intercepted at the goal line by Malcolm Butler. Unreal. Malcolm Butler, who almost made
in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Only tracks, pro name, no gimmicks.
Hey, Funday guys, Nick here. Nick's out of town this week. He asked me to film the little recap, so I'm going to try to make it quick. I think he's been doing a great job. We're, 5 weeks into it. Football's gotten better and better every week. I'm 2-3. But this week there's fantasy football and then there's real football. So I've just been mentally getting prepared for the big Sunday night game. We all know I'm a Pats fan. So I've got a cocktail. This is a small microbrew I just picked up. It's called the Colts Not Gonna Get 45. Pats Give Them 60. That's going to be our cocktail of choice while we, kind of drink this. I got my little Pats napkin, for snacks in the middle of this. But season's going great. I want to hit up John the Revelator. Led our league in scoring this week. 136. Put up 136 points against Inky's All-Stars. Came up with 129. Tough week to run in the bus, Lucas. Sal finally had Breeze and Cooks, sorry, Breeze and Cooks snap into it. Put up 40 points combined. Allen Robinson, Carlos Hyde had 18 points. So, that if Sal could get those two guys putting up points, his first two round picks, he's going to be in contention. Cooks had a garbage time touchdown there. Inky put up 40.99 points from Eli. AJ Green got you 10, but Eddie Lacy only got you 4, and Jimmy Graham only got you 4. That's just bad luck, hopefully those guys step up into their roles a little bit for the second half of the season for you. Next, Mondo Vision versus My Ball Zach Ertz. My Ball Zach Ertz, I love it. Mondo Vision hung 127.94 versus Reader's 95.2. So, Reader gave him a shot, but Mondo coming way over the top, throwing haymakers. Carson Palmer, 25.84. DeAndre Hopkins, 20.90. Gurley snapping into a week 2, 18.9. Gotta love the way that team's looking. Tough take on Jamal Charles, but we know, you're going to ride that waiver wire and come up with the big picks. Reader gets almost 30 points out of Phillip Rivers. Forte drops almost 20. Gore, 18. But Witten let you down. He only got 1.8 against the Pats. Antonio Brown with only 5. It sounds like you're only going to have to hang through that hassle for another week or two. Big Ben is a little further along in his process, than he could be. So that's good for you, Reader. Hang in there, kid. Mary McCheese down in Philadelphia dropped 130.29 on Trey's Funday Tube, the Nick on Nick Warfare, Nick Ricci versus Nick Latano. Aaron helps the commish out with 23.29. Le'Veon Bell gets 22. Just all around solid performance from the commish. Letano gets 26 out of Bradford, 24 out of the return of Antonio Gates. That's going to be a huge addition to the squad if you can get that. Your other guys, just they all put up, you know, that 5 to 10 points, but nobody scored a TD on the rest of your team, Letano. That's a tough break. So, you know, you had a couple TDs in the air. You're in that high points range, you know, most weeks. Hang in there. We like the way your squad's looking. Pardon me, I farted. Took down a chiclet last week, week five. Aiken dropping 121-26 versus K-Fly's 100.31. Aiken showing that you gotta, if you make moves in this league, it can pay off for you. Not to say that his trading partners, it's not going to work out for them either, but he makes the trade before the week, gets 31.7 out of Devontae Freeman and 23.5 out of Eifert. So he gave up Gronk to, you know, lead that kind of team as that kind of rock if he stays healthy. But Eifert dominating the tight end corps and giving you a big score this week, a lot of points. Down a chiclet, the funniest thing I've ever seen in my life. K-Fly gets 20 out of Edelman, 4-set, coming on strong, another week over 20 points. But, you know, you play half the teams in the league, you would have won, Flinter, but, you know, it's the draw of the dice. A little hot here. So, you know, week five, very solid with the league. Our undefeated team, Captain Curl's crew, takes down the Sunseed Choir. Curly making trades, going, what he's hoping to do is fill out, I think, the sure thing in his lineup, added Gronk. Gronk only got him 7.7 this week, but it didn't matter. Brady, coming up huge, 37 points. ODB goes out with a hamstring injury after he drops 20 points on Sunday Night Football. Jeremy Hill only gets you 3. You got to be a little nervous about that. Curly's making deals, picking guys up on the waiver wire. So he's fighting. He's not resting on his lawyers. They're undefeated. I have the matchup against the captain and the Curls this week, so we'll see how that shakes out. Sachi Choir, Payton, only giving you 9.39. I played him in my DraftKings league. I thought he was going to go into Oakland to at least, you know, play overly acceptable. It didn't happen at all. Got to be worried about that. There's guys out there on the waiver wire who are putting up more points than Peyton Manning. That's going to be a decision on the manager to see how long you tote that out there, especially as the temperature gets colder. Doug Martin spots you 37. You know, and a half points. That's a gift from the gods of Tampa Bay. I had Charles Sims. He got me over, I think, like 15 points or something like that. So what a backfield. What a day. I took the over in that game, so I was very happy with all the Tampa Bay scoring. Houston D, 0 points. Really killed you there, Reader, so, you know, step on up, Scotty, and, you know, make a trade. See what you got. Maybe see if you can't shop Peyton out there, you know, and see how things shake out. You know, finishing out the, rounding out the rest of this league here, the Trobe's weak sauce. I took down Capozzi. Capozzi got 22 out of DeMarco. But he kind of lost his magic with Ladarius Green, the tight end from San Diego. So hopefully you're working on that kind of next slot. My thought is I think you were a little busy this weekend. You know, you were struggling with that defense. Had to pick up the I think the you ended up going with San Diego late, you know, Sunday night for Monday. So, you know, I think there's more weeks to come. Still a very solid team. Just didn't get those touchdowns. You got to get those touchdowns. A lot of luck there. So, you know, not your fault. I think you're going to stay strong. I got 23 points out of the Denver D. That was huge. 15 out of Charles Sims. Yeldon finally stepped up and, you know, got me 13 points. Alex Smith, I had about 10 minutes before game time. I had Jay Cutler as my quarterback, and they were playing each other, Cutler and Alex Smith. I dropped Cutler, went with Alex Smith. Cutler scores the touchdown with like zero time left to just beat Alex Smith. So, you know, I lost a couple points there in that manager decision, but generally was, you know, still pretty happy with it. So that's kind of the quick recap of the teams. I just wanted to take one moment and, you know, just as, you know, Christmas time is coming, birthdays, year-round type things, there's, you know, you might want to make a card, you know, for, you know, somebody in your life. You're thinking about them, and you just want to find a way to, you know, add a little creativity and spot to your life. So, you know, we picked up this glue product. Seems to stick things together. I'm a big fan. Elmer's, we know it well. So, you know, not too much, not a lot, just a dot. Our teachers used to tell me at, you know, Morningside Elementary. And, you know, but I actually like using a lot of glue. I load things up with glue because I don't want them to slip or maintain. So, you know, I try to go through, I don't know, maybe 100, 200 bottles of glue a year. You know, I think it's an important product. There's, I'm not sure, you know, the kids used to eat this in school. Like, I'm not sure if it's a vegetarian. Where does glue come from? But you know, let's give the Elmer's School Glue a review here. You know the rules. One bite and score. I'm gonna go with a 4.6 for the Elmer's Glue. It's probably on the high end, but enough of the arts and crafts project. One last thing I want to get to real quick. Thanks for watching. With Ricci out of town, I thought it would be cool if we just very quickly went over the top scorers at each position. QBs, Andy Dalton is the number one scoring QB in all of fantasy football. He's put up 156 points. Aaron Rodgers put up 155 points on the year so far. So Donna Chicklet picked him up, has him on a squad. Tony Romo going down's gotten him the number one QB in football. Carson Palmer, 141.99. Heck of a player for Mondo Vision. I think it's Mondo Vision. The top wide receiver, I've got Julio Jones. He's put up 99.5. But Larry Fitz, 96.5 points on the year for Curley, dominating that late draft. Every one of Curley's picks is just paying off wherever he took them in their slots. I still love DeAndre Hopkins. I wasn't a believer before the year, and I've completely turned around. That guy is just a monster, and if only he had any kind of a team around him, it's embarrassing what they give him. That guy's awesome. Antonio Brown, Travis Benjamin for Trace Funday Tube is the fifth-ranked guy, 77.4 points. So who knows, you know? So just goes to show you, pick up the guys, follow them week to week. You could pick your team up. Every one of these slots has guys that we all could have picked up. Top tight ends. Tyler Eifert on the year, 70.2 points, leading the league in scoring for tight ends. Gronk has 69. Gary Barnage has 63. Travis Kelce, 52. Charles Clay, 45. So a pretty big drop-off. I'm pretty sure Eifert was out there at least at the end of week one. You know, and a lot of guys said to pick him up, so... Heck of a move there. Andy's been shopped and traded. So we're going to see how that plays out. If good Andy can stay as his running mate. Lastly, top RBs. Shirts off to Devontae Freeman. You know what I mean? Like that guy, 129.5 points. And did the guy even play week one? The guy he replaced looked dominant. And now he's back and he's sitting on a Wally Pipp sitting on a bench. but 129 points. The next highest guy, RIP, you know, Mondo Vision, Jamal Charles, 95 points. That's it for the year. But Devontae Freeman is 30 points ahead of the second-place guy. Bananas! Matt Forte, 84. Doug Martin, 81. Fuck you, Doug Martin. Carlos Hyde, 72. Great play by John the Reveler. John the Revelator. Yeah, so that's kind of just, you know, the top guys. You know, give it a quick look on your thing. It's cool to see these top guys. Tyrod Taylor's the fifth-ranked quarterback. He's still out on waivers. I think he's hurt this week. He's got a doubtful or a questionable against his name. But there's guys out there. You can make moves. You can pick things up. I'm going to enjoy the rest of this fine craft, small batch beer here. Sunday night, should be an awesome time. 8:30 at night. Anybody wants to get bimmed and watch it, let me know, because I think the Pats are going to do well. I hope you all do well, except when you're playing me. What a great league. Thanks for playing. Thanks for watching. Ricky will be back next week. Thanks for letting me take over for the week, Ricky. Have a good one, guys.
Hello, guys. Thanks for coming to my ChiliCon Carnival. This is the dumbest thing you've ever done, Cartman. Oh, it won't be so dumb when Scott Tenenbaum arrives. I suggest you stay to see the fireworks. Oh, we will. Trust us. We wouldn't miss this. What's so funny? Oh, nothing. It's just cool how you're going to get Scott Tenenbaum back. Is Radiohead here yet? Not yet, but they will be. Yeah, sure.
Hello, Eric.
Hey, Chef.
I made some chili to enter into the contest.
What contest?
This is a chili cook-off, ain't it?
Huh? Oh. Yeah, I guess it is. Here, I just put it over here.
It's my special recipe.
Scott Tenenbaum! How are you, Scott? Thanks so much for coming.
Oh, I wouldn't miss this for anything.
Likewise. Well, come on, you've got to see the penny.
Just a second, don't you want to taste my chili first?
Well, yeah, but there's a special guest coming, and I want you to be near the penny when they arrive.
Well, I don't want it to get cold. I think I can win first prize.
All right, Scott, let's go over to the judging table and we'll try the chili first. God damn it.
All right, I guess we should taste each other's chili, huh?
Yeah, this chili looks pretty good. Here's mine.
Mmm. I don't know. Your chili is good, Cartman, but I think mine is better. Try it.
All right. Hey, this is great.
It's a special recipe.
Ah, this is really good, Scott.
I'm glad you like it so much, because now that you're almost finished, I have something to tell you.
What? You mean about how you put pubes in your chili?
What?
Yes, I'm afraid this isn't your chili, Scott. I switched it with Chef's. It's delicious, Chef. I hadn't planned on that. What I did plan on, however, was that my friend Stan and Kyle would betray me and warn you that the Chili Con Carnival was a trap. I assumed that they would tell you that I had trained Dankin's pony to bite off your wiener. What they didn't tell you was that Dankin's is a crazy redneck who shoots trespassers on sight. Knowing that you would go and try to do something to the pony, I warned Mr. Dankin's that violent pony killers were in the area. I also knew that you wouldn't go yourself for fear of having your wiener bitten off. You would most likely send your parents. And I'm afraid that when Mr. Dankin spotted them on his property, he shot and killed both your parents.
Well, they was trespassing and I was protecting myself. I have my rights.
My mom and dad are dead?
I came just in time to see Mr. Dankin giving his report to Officer Barbrady. And, of course, to steal the bodies. After a night with the hacksaw, I was all ready to put on my chili con carnival so that I could tell you personally about your parents' demise. And, of course, feed you your chili. Do you like it? Do you like it, Scott? I call it Mr. and Mrs. Tenenbaum chili.
Oh, my God! Oh, my God!
I made you eat your parents. Jesus Christ, dude!
My mom and dad are dead! No! No!
Excuse me.
Who are you?
We're that band, Radiohead. Jeez, what a little crybaby. You gonna cry all day, crybaby? You know, everyone has problems. It doesn't mean you have to be a little crybaby about it.
Come on, guys, let's go. This kid is totally not cool.
Yeah, that's the most uncool kid I've ever met.
Little crybaby.
No, wait! Wait! Oh my god, oh my god!
Yes! Yes! Oh, let me taste your tears, Scott. Your tears are so yummy and sweet. Dude, I think it might be best for us to never piss Cartman off again. Good call. Oh, the tears of unfathomable sadness. Yummy. Yummy, you guys. That's all, folks.